Welcome back to our video series. My name is Marek. I'm a software engineer at SourceGraph. In this video, we're going to look at using search filters. Filters allow you to narrow down, refine, and improve your search results. So let's look at a few of the most useful and most powerful search filters supported by SourceGraph. First off, the language filter. The language or lang filter allows you to narrow your search so that you only see results in a particular programming language. Next, the repository or repo filter. With the repo filter, you can constrain your results to a particular repo or a particular set of repos. The repo filter supports regular expressions so you can match the repo path. For example, this use of the repo filter is searching in any repo that contains the string Python anywhere in its repo path. This example will match repos that end in Linux. To use the repo filter, you can either type it directly into your query or use the list of dynamically generated repositories in the sidebar. This list of repos that are listed in the sidebar are dynamically shown based on how many results were found in each repo in descending order. Once you're searching within a single repo, for example, after you've clicked on one of the repo filters in the sidebar, you'll also see a branches section in the sidebar as well. This lets you switch to searching on a non-default branch in that repository. If you use this, you'll see the rev filter. The rev filter lets you specify the revision you want to search on. This can be a branch name, it can be a tag name, or even a specific commit. Next, the file path filter. It can be useful to limit your search results to a particular file. Say you only want results from a particular directory because that's where test files are stored, or only file paths that match a certain regular expression. To narrow down by file path, use the file filter in your query. Here's an example of that. Next, the content filter. So sometimes you need to escape SourceGraph's search query syntax. For example, if what you're looking for has the same name as one of SourceGraph's filters. To do that, use the content filter and wrap the query in quotes after it. So here's an example of searching for the actual string lang. Without escaping it, it wouldn't work because lang is the name of a SourceGraph search filter. Next, negating filters. So by default, our filters are inclusive. You're saying what you want to find and where to find it. But sometimes you may want to exclude some results. You can use any filter to exclude results by negating it. To do that, add a minus sign in front of the filter. So here's an example of negating a lang filter. And in this case, we'll get results from all files except those that are in the given language. All right, so to recap, we looked at different kinds of filters that you can apply to your searches and how to use them.